and welcome. World Cup here in Lyon. Leg one got underway just about a week ago now in Herning, but we turn our attention now to this fabulous French venue, Lyon, who host leg two. And what a day of dressage we have coming up. Nine legs in total, nine qualifiers taking place in nine countries over the next 6 months with the aim of reaching the final in Leipzig, in Germany, next April 2022. Of course, the 2020-2021 season was cut very short due to the pandemic, but we have our fingers very firmly crossed for this year and next, moving on to those finals. Well, hope you're getting settled and getting sorted for today's dressage, the Grand Prix, and tomorrow the Grand Prix special, the freestyle. We welcome our judges and of those five, the president of the grand jury, Francis Birbeck from the Netherlands, Isabelle Jude from France, and E. Catherine Boost from Germany, and H. Dr. Jean-Michel Woudier from France, M. and Suzanne Barrett from Denmark at B. This amazing arena hosting the second leg of the Western European League. The Grand Prix starts with our first down the centre line at 7.30 UK time, 8.30 local time in France. And the dancing horses are back indoors for all this indoor World Cup season. Well, as I said, we're very excited to be here in Lyon, leg two, leg one in Herning just a week ago, and it was on home soil for the young lady that 12 months ago romped to victory with the Bohemian, but this year with Athlon Guards Cassidy stole the show 87.115 with her fellow compatriots in second, Karina Kassegrun with Helene's Danciera, two Danish one plus at the top of the leaderboard, 86.395 for Karina, and then Ninia van Dier for the Netherlands, third MS. This is how things look though here today, and first to go at 8.30 will be Anne-Sophie Serre with Actuel de Massa for France, followed by Antonia Ramel for Sweden, Curiosity, Catherine Dufour, new horse for her, Vamos Amigos, the nine-year-old for Denmark, third out. And then further down, Marie-Emilie Bretonneau from France, horse of Jazz, with then eighth on the block. It will be Boston STH with Denise Neckerman, the last to go before the first break in the arena. Followed then by Antrop Guards Athilia, Nana Schoberg Mera for Denmark, Damien Michels for Belgium, Rina Schultz, Auburn Vincent, Sedona Hall, then Tamar Zistra, Frederick Vandres, Duke of Britain, Isabel Vert, Vargoles. Well, what could she do? The 16-year-old mare, very much on form for Germany. And then last to go, Beatrice Ferris-Elas, elegant 16 combinations coming forwards for the short Grand Prix here this morning. And as I mentioned again, our first go, 8:30 local time, 7:30 here in the UK. And don't forget tomorrow, Grand Prix special, the freestyle. That is around 4 o'clock local time, 3 p.m. UK. We'll be bringing all of that action live on FEI TV, powered by Clip My Horse. Leg two here in Lyon, leg one in Herning, and it is 9 opportunities to qualify with, within 9 countries. And it's just 6 months of qualifying with the hope of qualifying for those finals in Leipzig, in Germany, in April next year. Judges in position. And fabulous scenes of our judges. Big those judging platforms. There's a lot of room to move. Our 5 judges around the arena. They've got very much different opinions, different views. Isabelle Judet, Katrina Boost, Francis Birbeck, my boy, Jean Michel Boudier, and Suzanne Barrop. 5 Grand Jury members.
En H, Katrina Boost pour l'Allemagne. En M, pour la France, Jean Michel Boudier.
It's interesting to see today Catherine Dufour with her 9-year-old, Vamos Amigos, owned by Sarah Pidgley, and Catherine herself. Well, the Pidgley's very much in the news of the dressage at the moment, with Gio being passed over now into the young hands of Annabelle Pidgley, the junior medalist. That's brought so much joy to Charlotte, but she felt that it was time for him to move on and give somebody else a chance of learning the ropes. Well, make sure you're sitting comfortably, sit back, relax, and enjoy the next few hours of top-class dressage here in Lyon, the host of Leg 2 of 9. This is the Short Grand Prix presented by Criara. Early start for many. Just about to make their way, there they go, into the arena, our first that we see into this beautiful arena. It is representing France, Anne-Sophie Serre. Anne-Sophie riding the 11-year-old mare, Actuel de Massa. This 11-year-old mare by Pastor Goublous. And 16 riders coming forward, owned by Sylvain Massa and Arnaud Serre. Ranks 446th in the world, 44 years of age. This Lusitan Le Maire, Actuel de Massa, representing France, our first to go. Well, Anne-Sophie herself, who represented France at the 2011 European Championships in Rotterdam with Le Gurrier, 10 years ago now. Actuel de Massa, this mare, her last outing last month in Le Mugello in Italy. Scored just over 70% in the Grand Prix and the freestyle. get those trending scores, bottom left-hand side of your screen. And that mark is the average mark from the five judges, 7.3 for the extended trots. Great to have a number of you watching. Don't forget that if you want to judge along, then you can download the Spectator Judging app, and you can judge along via your Google Play Store on your Android phone or the App Store on your iPhone. Simply download the Spectator Judging app and judge along. Good to see that a few of you are watching already. A number of very keen enthusiasts. Purcell just messaged in saying he was looking to watch Poe, but can enjoy dressage now until Poe starts. Poe, of course, the last five-star of the year in the Pyrenees eventing. I'm just going to try and minimise my screen because I don't know about you, I'm very jumpy screen. Never easy going first. These riders would have been up very early this morning, had a warm up before they came in here. Just say this mare has not really done anything wrong. They've done some very nice work. Lusitana's is certainly a breed amongst her own, and there's some very nice Lusitanas on the scene. I rode a couple of them, based with Peter Storr for a long time. Peter, who's done a lot of commentary, a lot of judging all around the world, as well as being a top-class rider himself. And they're lovely to ride. They give their enormous hearts. Transitions that you see just bringing them personal down by the looks. Yeah, I think we're all struggling a little bit with the pictures this morning, just jumping around. So bear with. Hopefully it'll sort itself out. But our first to go, Anne Sevisser and Actual de Massa, our trailblazers representing France. Maybe they're restarting it because my pictures have completely gone. I think that's probably what they're doing. is just restarting the pictures. At least I hope that's what's happening. I think that's what they did. I think they just had to rebuffer, because for me this is a little bit better now. And that just confirms by the team that it has restarted. It was very jumpy, and I think that was the case for everybody. So first to go, we'll get the scores up as soon as we can for Anne-Sophie and Acta.
We have a fabulous lineup indeed in this FAI World Cup Short Grand Prix presented by Korea. Obviously today we are in the Short Grand Prix tomorrow, the Grand Prix Freestyle, and we are in the second leg of the FAI World Cup.
Well, here is our second to go. The score not appeared yet, but let's see if we can find another way for you. And the answer is no, not yet.
we'll keep trying.
Well, there is the score. There was the score. There is the score. And the score for Anne-Sophie Serre, actual de Massa, and the judges' marks ranging from 67.368 up to 71.184, 69.605 for our first to go here this morning, Anne-Sophie Serre and Axel de Massa. As we welcome our Swedish combination, this is Antonia Rammel. Antonia, 36 years of age. She's ranked 42nd in the FBI World Rankings with the Holsteiner Gelding Curiosity, representing Sweden. Curiosity by Klinsmann II, the Damsar Carpaccio. And this is owned by Antonia herself. Very good horses, Antonia. Two-time Olympian. No, in fact, just one. She didn't go to... I thought she was in Rio. She didn't. She made her Olympic debut for Sweden in Tokyo with Brother de Jour. He's been such a good horse for her. He's taken her to Europeans and to a team bronze at the 2019 European Championships in Rotterdam. Brother de Jour, along with Curiosity, her two main competition horses. A lovely square halts for the diagonal pair in the rain back. Losing some uniformity in the rain back steps. All around the world, Rome, Italy, with the Camilla watching from Rome. And then we have Casita watching from Bulgaria, Nicole from Adelaide, one of my favorite places, Deborah from Victoria, Australia, Las Vegas for Laurie Gibson. Well, we missed coming to the finals in Las Vegas. We went into lockdown. We were supposed to be there for the finals in Las Vegas. We were so excited. We literally were within weeks of going. Nadia, South Africa. Wow. Great to have you all with us. So as we start with this canter work and the zigzag line down the centre line, you're straight into it. You're straight into the mix of things. And watching Curiosity as he started in his canter work, I wondered whether he would just get a little bit tight, a little bit tense. Tracy watching from Costa Rica. Natash, your bestie, is watching from London. Natasha Baker, who did, she commentated at Herning. She'll be doing the highlights program come Friday afternoon, and she's watching from London. She is a little star. Of course, picking up a few more of those gold medals in Tokyo as well. She was commentating on Herning. If you missed any of that, then do go back and watch at your leisure. The 11 ones on the centre line between pirouette to the right and the pirouette to the left. And then 6 to 9 strides around on the circle. Yeah, 10p 7.5. There's no getting away from it, you know, they've got to be as straight as a die coming down that centre line with those one-time changes. Great air time in the passage. Watching for the transitions in and out of the passage, the Piaf. And you can just see they're losing a little bit of the fluidity in those transitions. And the, you know, he's 12 years old. Good hold to finish. And showing that he is a little bit further on in his training than the mare that we saw in the Lusitana, the first to go with the Massa. Maddie watching from Australia. Jutta, hi Jutta, long time no see from Finland. And also San Luis, Denmark. All over the world, people watching leg two. Well, that was a very nice performance from Antonio Ramel. There is a final general impression score. We don't have all those collectives now, we just have that general impression score. And the range of marks from 69.737 up to 72.105. 71.211 for the Swedish combination. Antonio Ramel and the 12-year-old by Klinsmann, Curiosity, take an early lead. Well, the next combination I'm very excited about because they won, not as a combination. Catherine Dufour, she won in Herning on home soil. She's very much a lady on very, very good form. She's had some amazing results. A rider that I kept an eye on ever since she popped into the dressage world on a very good little pony called Moonlight all those years ago, back 2006, I think it was. She really has solidified herself as one of the very best. She's medalled at juniors, ponies, juniors and young riders. She has been herself runner-up, silver medalist. That was with Bohemian. She's ranked second in the FBI World Rankings, 29 years of age, with the gelding Vamos Amigos. She's a two-time Olympian, actor of Guards Cassidy, the horse that she won in Herning, leg one. And Bohemian, she won the individual bronze medal on in Tokyo. Bohemian, a horse that literally owes her nothing. Today though, with the Vamos Amigos, owned by Sarah Pichy and Catherine Dufour, 9 years old, by Vitalis. Sarah Pidgley. The Pidgleys I mentioned in the build-up, very much in the news at the moment with Annabelle Pidgley. Ooh, picking up the, not picking up, now purchased the rise in Gio Charlotte Desjardins' horse. Gio, the little pocket rocket that she rode to medals in Tokyo and at the European Championships in Hagen. But Catherine with this 9-year-old. Didn't even there when he had that spook. He's going to. He's not, well, not seen many things like this. And even as a 7-year-old, when we went into lockdown 2 years ago almost, you think we had no crowds, we had nothing. So these horses now only just learning what crowds are about. There's not many people here this morning. You've got to be a very keen enthusiast to come and get your seat. And there are a few slowly coming in. Got great elevation, really good with the hind leg. Looking at that hind leg, acting like a piston. Always interested to see the young horses in their walk in the Grand Prix, and he's got a beautiful walk. See the transitions, Piaf, Passage, Piaf. The mark for his Passage, 8. We've got Holly watching from North Yorkshire, God's own country. Stephen from Burma. And Cassandra watching from New Zealand. Straight into this canter zigzag. He looks like he's got a very good brain, doesn't he? Just here. Ooh, a little mistake there. That's my fault. Just as I said, he looks like he's got a very good brain, and then that mistake. Good 2-time changes. Uphill, he's put that gremlin to bed now. So we come into the pirouettes. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 6 to 9. And for a young horse like that, 8. The 11 one-time changes on the center line. So, you know, again, it's quite a lot for a young horse, isn't it? For the pirouette, the one-time changes to the pirouette again. I think he did those very nicely. She rode him very sympathetically. Very good transition. Over very quickly this test, hence the name Short Grand Prix. We'll watch him now, see how smooth he was from the Passage to the Piaf. Yes, there's a little bit of movement, but you'd expect that from a young horse. And again, she's riding him in and out of those transitions. Something that can be polished and tightened up, tidied up. You know, she said in her post-interview after her appearance and her win with Attrick Guards Cassidy at Herning, in Herning, whether that may be his last one of the season, she didn't really know. She'd let him tell her, and she said he felt brilliant and felt better than he's felt for a long time. This young horse coming up through, giving her yet another horse at Grand Prix level, and this is what is and why these riders are quite remarkable in bringing on their next batch. You've got to have those new ones coming through. Well, the score then, 73.895. and her range of marks from 72.105 all the way up to 75.658. Interestingly, our judge at E has been the lowest, and now with Catherine is the highest. We'll keep spots on the scores on the boards. 73,895. But for now, Catherine Dufour goes into the lead with Vamos Amigos, the 9-year-old, owned by herself and Sarah Pidgley, 73.895. And Antonia Rommel for Sweden, second. So next to go, this is Yessine Ramouni, representing Morocco, 37 years of age, ranked 166th in the world ranking with the Dutch bred stallion All At Once. Well, All At Once, the horse that took him to his very special second Olympic Games. He rose for Morocco in London with Floresco. And then All At Once made the trip to Japan and competed as an individual. Saw that very definite change of rhythm from the trot to the half pass, just making actually sure. I think he was just starting to look a little bit behind the leg there. In the hind leg, and just trailing the leg a little bit, and that will lose marks. The judge is looking for that airtime, looking for the moment of suspension in the hind foot, making sure that the hind end matches the front end, that it's not just the front end that's doing the work. Very quickly, we move into the zigzag on the centre line. Ooh. It's getting a bit tight, a little bit on the spot. You could actually see that Yessine Hemming did work quite hard in making that happen. Thank you. got the 11. This all happens quite quickly as well, from the extended back flying change and then into the drop work on the centre line. Blink and it's all over. We'll watch here the transition from the Passage to the Piaf. Looks like we're going to see it from head on, but just looking for that smoothness. No break in rhythm, and you saw clearly the break in the rhythm there from one to the other. Might think that they're riding their freestyle tests. They're not. It's a very clever person putting music to their tests on site, but all at once with Yasin Ramouni.
Il était le deuxième voyage olympique, dont celui de Rio Rex, en Artois, il y a 11 ans, un fils de grand-père qui est à bord du WPM. Voici ses notes, juge par juge, et la moyenne, 69,526.
Well, that score for Yasin Ramouni. Just having a look at this leaderboard. Ah, it's all sorted itself out. The horses' names have changed. I thought, goodness me, what is going on? So we'll bring you his score in just a second. We welcome Pierre Vola next to go. Well, Yasmin Ramouni all at once, 69.526. His range of marks from 67.237 up to 70.395. Well, this is Silver Moon's Marie Chen. Grey mare, 13 years old by Silver Moon, owned by Pierre Vola himself, representing France. Very experienced, a couple of Europeans. He's been to the Olympic Games back in Rio 2016. He rode then in Rio Medina El Tena. And with this horse, the grey, Silver Moon's Marie Chen, he had some pretty good results. They were fourth in Madrid just a few weeks ago. don't forget that we've got a lot of dressage coming up. We started in Herning, we moved here to Lyon, then Madrid, where Pierre was fourth with this horse, Madrid, 25th to 27th of November, then London, the XL Centre, new home for dressage for 2021, and then Mechelen sees out the 2021 year. We move on then to Amsterdam in January of 2022, Neumünster, Gothenburg, Zeltogenbosch, and then those finals in April, Leipzig in Germany. Silver Moon's Marie Chen. The grey. Pierre Boulle. Almost ran himself out of trouble, or ran himself into trouble, out of space. Going down that left-handed pirouette. Again, the transition didn't really happen where he wanted it to happen. She's 13, this mare, by Mai Zauber. Better out than she was in. To the Piaf. It can be quite disconcerting as well when you've got someone doing the music for you that's not put that music to the horses and they stop that music where they thought he should stop. And you know, that can just make you think, ooh, have I gone wrong? Where should I have stopped? What should I be doing? Well, there is the score for Silver Moon's Marie Chen and Pierre Boulle. Range of marks from 66.974 to 69.605. Didn't see the score. Just get that. Yeah, Pierre Boulle then, 68.184. Interestingly, we had one judge third and the rest of them in fifth. How the difference of opinion can really change. But four judges had him in fifth and one judge had him in third. But for now, he goes into fifth place. We've got three left to go, one for France, one for Spain and one for the Netherlands before the first short break in the arena. That is for what we've all got to love and know well is tractor dressage. With a arena rake, tractor dressage in the middle. It was a TikTok thing or just a social media thing during the Olympic Games. There was a child that said, "Mummy, is this tractor dressage?" Yes, it is. How do you explain? So our next to go and representing France will be Marie-Emilie Bretonneau with Courts of Jazz.
And for the moment, Pierre, on
We're a little bit ahead of time, in fact. A couple of moments ahead. We have 8 minutes between each test. And with it being a short Grand Prix, obviously, it's not an 8 minute test. And we're just running slightly ahead of time. The gates there, that's the in gates between the two Longines watches. The two lit up Longines watches. We will be underway very shortly once again. A quick run down the leaderboards, and it is at the top, Catherine Dufour and Vamos Amigos, 73.895 for Denmark. Second for Sweden, Curiosity and Antonia Ramel, 71.211. And in third, Actual de Massa and Anto Bizarre on 69.605. Well, a few more shout-outs I think we can afford to give, just to see who else is watching. Here comes our next to go. Just while we do that, let's give a couple of shout-outs. We've got Nicola Bingham watching from Western Australia, Christine Rippon from Mount Gambier, South Australia. Also, Judy from Adelaide. Julia Varlan says bonjour from Connecticut. Kelly watching from Belgium. Greg Smith giving a wave and a clap as well. Well, we now go to Marie-Amélie Bretonneau. She rides Courts of Jazz. Jazz, what a good horse he has been. Taken her to two European Championships now, back in 2017 in Gothenburg, and then had the pleasure of commentating on them in Hagen just a few weeks ago at their second European Championships. He's 17 years old now, and he just looks the picture of health. Love watching these two. They know each other incredibly well. She wouldn't have the biggest team of horses, and he has just been a brilliant campaigner. Love watching him, love these two, and it's a great heartwarming story. And this is a horse that's owned by Jean and Veronique Bretonneau, self-conseil by Lawrence, representing France. 40 years old, ranked 128th in the FBI World Ranking. This is the lovely thing about this sport, isn't it? We've seen a 9-year-old, we've seen a 17-year-old now. Ooh, little mistake coming out of the halt. So, yep, the judges. We'll have a rundown of the judges. Someone's just asked who the judges are. And the judges are today Isabel Judet at E, Catherine Wust at H, Francis Beerbach Van Roys at C, Jean-Michel Roudier at M, and Suzanne Barrett at B. They're the five judges. Hope that helps you out. Sure that in that halt, he immobilised the halt. He's quite keen to get on. somebody's just asked about who is riding for Holland. Well, we have Denise Neckerman in two horses' time. And then we also have Tamas Ristra, one of the last go, fourth last to go. So two more riders from Denmark. Marie-Emilie Bretonneau. And Courts of Jazz. He's taken her just all over the world, all over the European circuit, and in this Western European League, she's been very much part of the scene for quite a long time now. I love watching them, and I don't, you know, it doesn't always go right. There are a few mistakes, but he's sort of just such a great horse, and giving her an experience that is like no other. And I always say it's very easy to sit and criticize, but actually Marie is there. She's worked herself to compete in this arena. We're not there, she is, and well done her. And with this horse at 17, she's kept him sound, fit, healthy, and not only healthy in mind, but healthy in body. And he looks keen, he looks very happy, ears pricked the whole way through. And how lovely it is to dust off the tailcoats, dust off the boots, and be back in the arena. Madison, who's in first place. Well, it's Catherine Dufour, Vamos Amigos. She's out in front, 73.895. We've just got two left to go before the first break. But Catherine Dufour for Denmark leads with Vamos Amigos on a score 73.895. Well done. Picked up a little bit of momentum, and the mark started climbing as she went towards the end of her test. Bless his heart. Great to see. She's smiling. Yeah, waving to the crowds. Quite early, isn't it? They're still there. I mean, what's the time here in the UK? It's 8:15. In the UK, quarter past 9 in France, and they're very keen to come and watch, and there'll be a lot more later on as well. Well, there we have the score for Marie-Emilie Bretonneau, Courts of Jazz, a range of marks of 66.184 up to 69.342. Score very quickly. And bring you just a second. Updating. But what a lovely horse he is. He's an out and out trier.
Overall score 68.5534 Marie-Emilie Bretonneau. You, public, gave 69.
And don't forget, if you would like to judge along, then do. You can download the Spectator Judging app on your iPhone in the App Store or the Google Play Store on your Android. Search for the Spectator Judging app, download it, join in, and see how close you are to our judges. 68.553 for Marie-Emilie Bretonneau and Courts of Jazz goes into fifth place. And we welcome into the arena very shortly our Spanish combination. And it will be Juan Matu Dimon with Quantico. And here he is, just making his way through the tunnel from the warm-up arena. Rides the 15-year-old Hanoverian Quantico by Fighting Fit. owned by himself. Quantico that took him to the World Equestrian Games in trial back in 2018. A rider that's made his way up through the youth program, picked up his individual gold with Dani Yimas at the Junior European Championships back in 2015. Backed that up with an individual bronze at the Under 25 Championships 4 years ago in 2017. In Austria with this horse Quantico. Got a good number of horses competing out there, 23 years of age now. Juan Manuel Gimel, ranked 89th in the world, the FIA World Rankings, the gelding Quantico for Spain. Had a brilliant ride with this horse in Aachen, finished individually fifth. He rode, I thought, out of his socks. He really did a brilliant job. I think definitely, although 15, this is definitely a horse that is going to take him places. Movements and the transitions are on par. Very good. Very nice and diagonal pairs. Give that board a bit of a shift. See there, Quantico just having a look around. What's going on? Juan Manuel Gimel staying very relaxed. He's very clever there. You see now he picks his rein up from the walk into the canter. Thought of the zigzag line there. Nice work in the twos. Pat down the neck. Yeah, seven across the board. You can see there that Catherine Dufour had 4.4 there for her zigzag line when she had that mistake, but interesting watching him. I thought a couple of times he just lost the quality of the zigzag. Level ones or two or good. little wry smile there. Obviously having a good time. He's gone into seconds. Woo woo wait. I remember watching this horse in Aachen and just thinking, you know, watching them together, they grew and grew over the course of the few days that they were there. And watching him here, just watch the smoothness in. Yeah, keep the activity. And then the smoothness out, forwards. It's just all about keeping that forwards momentum without losing any regularity in the step. He's certainly giving Catherine a run for her money. And a good hope to finish. Very happy. Juan Mathieu Guimont and Quantico. Well done, representing Spain. So Catherine Dufour leads. Gone 73.895. And the score just coming in for Juan Mathieu Guimont. Quite a showman already at 23. Loves the crowds, loves the atmosphere. Yeah, giving the crowds a kiss as well. Blowing them a kiss. They're very appreciative, these riders. And the score, 71.842, goes into second place with the range of marks of 69.474 up to 72.5, and goes into second behind Catherine Dufour. So we'll explain that bottom mark again and how it works. It's at that stage, we'll explain it when they come back onto the screen. I think that's the easiest way of doing it. I'm getting a little bit confused, and I'm not surprised, it is quite confusing. So Denmark leads, Spain second, Quantico, and this young man goes into second, Juan Mathieu Guimont, 71.842. We just got one left to go before the first of the breaks, and this is her, representing the Netherlands. This is Denise Neckermann. Denise riding Boston. A 15-year-old Dutch bred by Johnson, the Damsa Quattro, owned by the Neckermann family. So Boston STH, I never know whether it's Boston STH or Boston South. I don't know whether it's just a prefix after it. I've always wondered. Well, Boston is pretty much one of her only rides internationally, a horse that she brought up through the young riders. She's 27 years old now, ranked 72nd in the world with this Dutch bred stallion. Boston brought her two young rider silver team medals and three under 25 silver team medals as well, with an individual bronze back in 2007. It's lovely that we've got the World Cup season back underway. Dancing horses indoors for the World Cup season 2021-22. Comes up very quickly, doesn't it? As soon as you pick up the canter and then straight into the zigzag. Just to keep it moving. And that was the result, 6.7. Down to her final halts. Denise Neckerman with Boston completes the test. The 15-year-old stallion by Johnson, the Damsar Quattro, Dutch bred. It'll be quite interesting to see where she goes. I think she was trending around the sort of 71. We've got three scores above 70, and here we go, 71.079 goes into fourth place, ranging from 69.211 up to 72.632. And Denise Neckerman goes into fourth place ahead of Anne Levisseur and Akhil Damassa on 69. Four scores now, breaking the 70% barrier, with Catherine Dufour, Vamos Amigos, leading going into the break with 73.895. Juan Manduquimo and Contigo for Spain, second, 71.842. Antonio Ramel, Curiosity for Sweden, third, 71.211. Well, after the break, we have then Nana Skoburg-Merrells with Atrop Garza-Filia, followed by Damien Michels, Intermezzo Fonhet, Mia Dahlhoff, then Karina Schultz, Tarantino, Morgan Van Valsant, Sir Donahue, Temoz Istra, Hexagon's Double Dutch, Frederick Barnes, Duke of Britain, and then Isabel Wirtz, Isabel with Var Gold, she do here today, and then Beatrice Barasadat, Elegance the last game. There is the leaderboard, Catherine Dufour, Vamos Amigos leads going into the break for Denmark, 73.895, with Spain's Juan Manduquimo, Montico second, 71.842, and Sweden's Antonio Ramel, Curiosity third, 71.211. Denise Neckerman there, last to go before the break. Boston, the Netherlands in fourth, 71.079. We're on a break now. The next to go will be at 9:44 local time, 8:44 UK time. So just about 10 or 11 minutes. Grab yourselves a quick cup of tea, cup of coffee, and be back here settled for the next eight to go. 9:44, we're back.
Either on the new or the app store, select
Sky Dressage donc Western European League 2021. Les quatre ligues font de ce circuit un véritable rendez-vous mondial et offrent aux athlètes du monde entier l'opportunité de se qualifier pour la finale qui aura lieu en Allemagne, à Leipzig, en avril 2022. La FBI Dressage World Cup est une des séries les plus prestigieuses du calendrier international de dressage. C'est donc avec beaucoup d'enthousiasme et d'impatience que nous découvrirons pour qui les portes de la finale s'ouvriront à l'issue des différentes étapes qualificatives de la saison. La Fédération Équestre Internationale souhaite bonne chance à tous les athlètes en compétition et encourage les fans à participer à la notation de la FBI E-League en téléchargeant l'application Spectator Judging App.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Longue Italian Concours Hippique International. Welcome to the FAMI Dressage World Cup 21-22. It is our pleasure to welcome you here to Lyon for this FAMI Dressage World Cup Western European League. Four leagues make this series truly global and provide athletes from all around the world with an opportunity to qualify for the final, which will be taking place in Leipzig, in Germany, in April 2022. As one of the most prestigious series on the international dressage calendar, it is with great anticipation that we watch this season's qualifiers unfold and reveal for whom the doors to the final will open. The FEI would like to wish every athlete competing the best of luck and encourage fans to participate in scoring in the FEI E-League by downloading the Spectator Judging app.
Bienvenue sur cette deuxième étape du circuit Coupe du Monde de l'Europe de l'Ouest.
Well, welcome back, and as you can see on your screen, the start list, and it will be Nanna Skjoldbjerg for Denmark first to go, followed by Damien Michaels from Belgium, and then Karina Schultz for Germany, Morgan Barbazor for France, Thomas Zistra for the Netherlands, Sexkens Double Dutch, Frederik Vaanderas, Isabel Vert, and then Beatrice Perez-Salat, the last to go of this group of eight for Spain. Two riders from Spain, and the first of those lying in second place. We saw him just a few moments ago, the young man, 23 years of age. It is Juan Mathieu Guimond, 71.842. with Quantico, but Catherine Dufour for Denmark leads the Most Amigos, 73.895. We're about to get back underway.
À la poursuite de la perfection, voilà ce dont il est question dans ce Grand Prix Coupe du Monde présenté par le Comité Régional d'Équitation Auvergne-Rhône-Alpes. Nous sommes très heureux de vous accueillir pour cette deuxième partie du Grand Prix qui nous tient encore à l'aide depuis 8h30 ce matin avec l'acte 2 qui sera demain vers 16h pour justement ce qui sera la danse avec les chevaux. Ce sont de véritables danseurs au mental d'acier qui vont venir nous rejoindre dans leur freestyle.
Well, our judge is getting back into position. Five judges, judge at sea, just about to make their way onto their little judging podiums. It is Francis Bierbeck van Ruij for the Netherlands, Catherine Wüst, Germany, and Jean-Michel Roudier all along this. All along that top side now as you see it, and then our two judges on the sides at B and at E. E, Isabelle Jude, and at B, Suzanne Barra.
Installez-vous confortablement, c'est maintenant que débute cette deuxième partie du Grand Prix FEI Dressage World Cup présenté par le Creux Ara, Comité Régional d'Équitation.
Well, the second leg here in Lyon, the first leg in Herning. And you can go back and watch that with commentary from British para-dressage rider, Olympian extraordinaire, Natasha Baker, who gave us the commentary from Herning. And of course, we move on to Madrid next, and Tash will be back to commentate on Madrid in November. We're very nearly there as well, aren't we? Just a few days of October left. This is Nana Skobo-Merrald. Well, what a journey she's had. Athrop Guards for Thilia. 16-year-old mare by IPS Grebaldi, the dam sire Donna Schlag. And this is owned by Blue Oars Apps. Of course, she rode Blue Oars Zack at the Tokyo Games back a few... Oh, it's such a long time ago now already, isn't it? It doesn't seem that long ago. But rider at Blue Horse Stud. Rides a lot of the Blue Horse horses. She rode a very stunning horse at Verdon in the young horse class, finished second. Blue Horse Touch of Olympic. But this is Nana Skobo-Merrald, Athrop Guards Athilia. The 16-year-old mare by Grebaldi. Othilia, former ride of Fiona Bigwood. Fiona, who took this horse up to top level, rode this horse at the Rio Games. Fiona, representing Great Britain. Catherine Dufour started this horse off, though, in the very early stages of her career for Denmark, and then to be back in Danish hands again. She is a lovely, lovely man. A short spell with Nedda Kirk Dingard as well. See there the leader and where Nana is at this stage in the game. Nana in purple, Catherine Dufour in the grey. Very relaxed this morning, this mare. Very clever, very tentative with the way she picked the rein up, trying to keep her up to the bridle, and they're wanting to work herself down. And just saying, ah, come on. All the time, thinking forwards and up. Quite sure why the rank is saying first when a leader here was ahead. Now she has gone back up through that zigzag, and it was the zigzag that let Catherine down with the Vamos Amigos. Just that 4.4 giving them that slight window of opportunity. Thank you. tiny bit stuck on the outs on the left pirouette. Nice. And out as well. Very good. Yeah, this has been the ride of her life. Really has. Very good performance from Nana Gobomerils at her guards Odilia. Well, I wonder where that will go. At the moment, it looks like it could be topping the leaderboard, which would mean Denmark 1-2. And confirmed, 75.342 takes the lead away from Catherine Dufour and her range of marks from 74.211 up to 76.447. 75.342 takes a fairly convincing lead. Denmark 1-2 now, but Mads Bolmigos and Catherine Dufour go into second. Nana leading the way. I think she's just realizing where that has put her on the leaderboard. A brilliant performance. And don't forget that if you want to judge along, then do download the Spectator Judging app in your App Store, on your iPhone, or in the Google Play Store, on your Android phone. And we've got a couple of messages coming in saying, it's lovely to be Danish. I couldn't agree more. You are doing very well, first and second. Nana Skovberg, Merold, Attrup Guards, Athilia, 75.342, leading the way. Well, our next to go. This is Domien Michels. Damien riding for Belgium, 38 years old, 93 in the FBI World Rankings, with the Belgian Warmbloods, Intermezzo von het Middelhof, by another one by Grabaldi, the Damser Blauchflug, owned by Mark Stino, 13-year-old gelding. Intermezzo von het Middelhof. Again, pretty much the only horse that he competes internationally, a horse that though did take him to European Championships earlier on this year in Hagen, and also a horse that took him a few weeks before that to the Tokyo Games in Japan. And Intermezzo von het Middelhof, representing Belgium. A horse with some very good international career results. Hagen wasn't their finest hour. They had a few mistakes in Hagen, but they're very, very exciting to watch. When they're on good form, you can see the horse has got quite hot already. Gavin Stockley watching from Wales, South Wales. Hope you're enjoying it. As I said, this horse, when he's good, he's very good. And Domian has to do a really good job, ride a really tactile test. See what happens here, because this is, I think this is where I saw this horse blow up before in the zigzag line. Damien very clear. Trying to keep this horse between his hand and leg, keeping him focused. Ooh, little spook there. And there's a fine line, I say it quite often. Fine line between expression and explosion. You want the horses to be expressive without exploding. Doing a very good job at the moment. Just keeping this horse's focus, keeping the horse's attention, keeping him interested. In the job in hand. Jane McLeod watching from Langley. In Canada. Langley, love Langley. Been over a few times to Thunderbird Horse Park. And yes, it is late. It is late for you guys. Well done for staying up. You can see a few more friendly faces in the crowd now, adding to the atmosphere. Domian Michels and Intermezzo von Het Mudelhof comes down into his final line.
La Belgique a été représentée dans ce Grand Prix Coupe du Monde et vous avez donc le seul couple belge qui a été dans vos applaudissements.
Yeah, great test. He should be very, very pleased with that. And looking forward to the freestyle tomorrow, not having to ride a set floor plan that sometimes doesn't always go your way. In the sixth place, another one to break the 70% barrier, 70.395 there for Domian Michels and Intermezzo von Het Mudelhof. Good job from him. Well done. Some very nice moments. And again, from what he's done to what he's wanting to achieve, and for this horse to stay with him, you can see how hot he got and how keen he was getting. And I thought Damien did a really good job at coercing this horse around the arena and giving him the confidence that he clearly needed on occasion, and to give him the hand that he needed holding every now and again was just brilliant. Well, as we wait, there's a spectator judging app, 70.574, so not too far away from what the judges thought as well. How close could you be? Do you want to judge along? Why don't you? You can download the spectator judging app on your iPhone in the App Store or in the Google Play Store on your Android phone. The next to go, representing Germany, this is Karina Schulz. Karina riding Sport Bird Schulz Tarantino by Toronto, the dam sire Carbid, 15-year-old gelding. The bell goes. Well, Karina Schulz. Very much making a name for herself. 29 years old. She's ranked 43 in the FBI World Rankings. Tarantino 5 by Toronto. Of course, that she rode into part of the team that won in Aachen.
pour une première ici à Lyon, elle représente l'Allemagne. Au nom de Félix et par vos applaudissements, madame, monsieur, on termine la chose avec Tarantino.
Let us all go ahead in the old age and carry our shows with Tarantino, just leaving the rest of course in a few seconds of her results with our judges and with you, thanks to spectator judging.
Et c'est Tarantino à 14 ans, Léon Martin de Toronto, il est dessus contre Alain Rien, il appartient à Richard Scholz. Quel plaisir d'avoir ce jeune diamant allemand. Deux fois 6 ses notes en E, 75-263, en H, 75%, en C, 76 et 75%. Elle était cette saison vainqueur du Grand Prix du Monde de Budapest. On va pouvoir vous souhaiter bienvenue ici à Lyon. Pour la France, sœur de rôle, voici Morgane Parchanson.
And the third round of France, she's a delivery of 1 and 40, 26 years of age. She's already been up to the Olympic Games twice, as well as the Europeans. Six times. Thank you.
Hamilton's in the lead. She's now just dropped down to fourth. She's got some very good horses. Diodoro, I think I mentioned him. Valero. Gretchen watching from British Columbia, Canada as well. Enjoying the dressage here this morning in Lyon. Well, Morgan Van Vansant with Sir Donald Hall. A few mistakes, and they were a little bit costly today, but still, it was a solid performance from the French combination. Gacha says, where's the start list? If you go to Longines Timing, I think there's a link in the previous comments, then there is a link there from Maya. Go and have a look at the start list and the results there. Very excited, Sir Donald Hall, as he leaves the arena. And from this morning, really, the first horse, there were only about a handful of people watching the dressage. The grandstand seating is certainly filling up in places. And there the score into fourth place, 72.079, with that range of marking from 70.921 up to 73.158. Morgan Van Vansant and Sir Donald Hall go into fourth place pour la France. Well, next up, it's back to the Netherlands as we watch some slow-mo highlights of Morgan's test. Yeah, lovely kiss at the end. These riders love their horses. Just about to make their way in. We'll see them mid-left screen into the arena. It will be Thomas Vistra. She comes under the tunnel. Hexagon's double dutch. Past the Longines Fox to the arena. Thomas Vistra with the Dutch bred Hexagon's double dutch 13-year-old stallion by Johnson. And the dam sire Ruby Quill, owned by Still Hexagon. And LFLB Yaron. Well, Thomas Vistra, around on the circuit for many, many, many years, and she's so much pride to the Netherlands. Hexagon's double dutch, a horse that she's been around on the circuit, whether it be Nations Cup, World Cups. She's certainly always came and given her all. She was in Herning just a week ago. She was in Aachen as well, competing at four-star level. So is Tamar Zistra. Line. Hexagon's double Dutch, 38 years of age, ranked 38th as well with the Dutch bred stallion. Hexagon's double Dutch. Lovely reach in his half pass and keeps a very good rhythm too. Always looking for the air time, the ground cover. Good halts at sea. Not quite in diagonal pairs the first step, then much better. Miscommunication there coming from the passage to Piaf. Well, I hope you can hear me. Natasha's just messaged in saying, are you okay? Can't hear you. So I'm not quite sure what's going on because of my monitor and on my mixing desk it is working. So hope it's working. I see into her two time changes. It just occasionally looks a little bit cheeky. Slightly gets ahead of her, but she does a very good job. You can see they're very careful with what she's asking. He's fast, isn't he? Very quick with his leg work. Tamar knows him very well, and she has to just keep ahead of him. Don't let him get too far in front of her. Be a very nice movement for her to ride in the extended canter and go bullet out of the gun, blast across the diagonal line, then sit, collect, change, and then into the trot work again before the final centre line. Boy. Thank you. music from the holiday, isn't it? Yeah, very good test. Tema Zvistra, Hexagon's double Dutch. He's a funny little horse, he really is. I say little, he's not. But he just is so much the enthusiast. Yeah, exactly. And, you know, she has such fun on him. He'd be one of those that would just make you smile every single day. And keep you on your toes too, I bet. A lovely test there from Tema Zvistra. And her score, 72.474, with her marks ranging from 70.789 up to 74.211. Goes into fourth place for the Netherlands. It's a very strong performance from her. It's Denmark 1, Germany 2, Denmark 3, the Netherlands 4.
72.474.
Just having a look up at the scoreboard. She should be pleased with that. She'd be very pleased with that. Well, why shouldn't she be? See here, just his enthusiasm. She has to keep a lid on it. She has to keep him very much on her side. A bit of red bling around the top of her boot. Match that of her tail coat and her hat. See here, I mentioned she's very quiet with her leg, very quiet with her leg aid, because he moves it, he reacts to her leg, sometimes in a way she doesn't expect. And I think that's true of a lot of the horses that we ride. You know, some days they can react one way and then the other, you think, well, I didn't get that before, why have I got that now? And that's just part of training and getting to know your horses. Well, we just have the three left to go, and it's 2 for Germany, 1 for Spain. Frederik Vaanderas is our next to come down the centre line with the DiMaggio sired Duke of Britain by Rubenstein. This is owned by Hof Castleman. Well, Hof Castleman, the host of the European Championships in Hagen, and what a facility that is. An amazing place, and the European Championships certainly enjoyed the hospitality of the Castleman family. Frederik Vaanderas, 21, he is ranked in the FBI World Rankings with the lovely gelding, Duke of Britain, by DiMaggio, 14 years old. Frederik himself, he rode in Herning, rode there Bluetooth. This time he brings forward Duke of Britain. Duke of Britain, the horse that he went so very well on and won the freestyle at London Olympia back in 2018, I think it was. A lovely test, a lovely horse, actually, and this horse can produce a fab test. He can do everything. He was part of the team that won in Aachen. He picked up a couple of lower placings there as well. Interestingly, going from 4 back up now to take the lead. To 117 international starts in his career with 28 wins. Won the Young Bulls Championships back in 2019 with Tsuchiro. System in Germany, he received the golden riding badge from the German Equestrian Federation. Very highly acclaimed badge to be presented. Lovely one-time changes. Great expression. You see here, I mean what I mean when the front end matches the back end. The back end matches the front end, keeping the power there, but allowing these horses to get too excited, too over exuberant in the front. Have the ability to sit, collect. Frederik Vander is Duke of Britain. He is the principal rider at Hof Castleman's. That wonderful facility in Germany. Hagen hosting the European Championships earlier on this year. He's 33 years of age now. 26th in the FIA World Rankings. Well, there is the score. Goes into the lead. New leader, Frederik Vander, Duke of Britain for Germany, 75.947. Range of marks from 74 to 76 from our five judges. Frederik Vander goes into the lead. So it's changing all the time. We've got two left to go. Well, Duke of Britain and Frederik Vanderus in the freestyle last year finished third, in the Grand Prix finished sixth. So it'll be interesting. 74, he's already done better than that. 74, he scored 12 months ago. About 2 years ago it was, 2019, 2020 season pretty much dried up, didn't it? But Isabel Vert is our next to go. Isabel riding Vargold, owned by Christine Arndt Krogman, 16-year-old mare by Blue Horse Don Shrewfro, the dam sire Sandro Hit. Vargold, Isabel Vert for Germany. She has won. I mean, it's just amazing what she hasn't won. Isabel, who first jumped into the international scene back in 1989 when she rode Weingart at the European Championships. Then again, she picked up her first gold. She's now 52, ranked fourth in the world. The Oldenburg mare, Vargold. At the 91 European Championships, she picked up team and individual gold with Gigolo. She's then had some amazing horses throughout her career. Baram Nicht, Satchmo, Don Johnson, Bella Rose. This horse by Gold, who has took her to Olympic glory, World Cup glory, European Championship glory. Just amazing to think she has won in her career. Now, 42 golds, 7 Olympic golds, 9 World Championship golds, 21 European golds, and 5 World Cup golds, 14 silvers, and a mere 5 bronzes. Individual silver from the Tokyo 2020 Games. Pleasure to watch. And I know that there were stories of her retiring. They were all rubbish. It was just the fact that she said she'd get to Paris and then see. She's 52, she has a family. She very much knows that career doesn't go on forever, and she wanted to reevaluate, see what horses she had. It wasn't anything to do with her retiring. It was merely the way that the press and the journalists read into that. Having spoken to her in Hagen, she said, rubbish. Very worrying time for her in Hagen as well. Bella Rose, the horse that she rode into silver in Tokyo, suffered with colic, but all is good. Interestingly, at this stage, behind Frederik Vanderes. Part of that team that won gold in Germany as well, with Bella Rose, Dorothy Schneider, Jessica Norvidavardl, teammates. Jessica, who took the individual golds, United States second, silver of Great Britain, the bronze, and gone into the lead. Gold is just an amazing mare. 16, looking absolutely picture perfect. Isabel always knows at the end of a test if she's done enough as well. Lots of support from the crowds, and it looks like she will go into the lead ahead of our last to go here. Isabel Vargols looking amazing. She's so exciting to watch, this mare. And she's still at the top. Individual silver, team gold in Tokyo. An amazing European championship she had as well. In Hagen, there it is, 78.421. A convincing lead for Isabel and Weigel. Germany, 1-2. Well, it is Germany 1, Germany 2 at the moment. Isabel, who took the silver at the European Championships in the special. But the last to go is for Spain. This is a turn of Beatrice Berasalat. She is riding Elegance. Well, Beatrice Berasalat, our last to go, riding the 12-year-old gelding, Dutch bred by Negro, same sire as Vallegro, and the dam sire Monaco, owned by S.L. Delba. Elegance for Spain. Beatrice now five-time Olympian. She went to her first games with Brilliant back in 1996, Atlanta, Georgia, and then on to Sydney, Athens, Rio, Tokyo. Elegance, the horse that she rode in Tokyo. She's 55. She's ranked 33rd in the FBI World Rankings. The Dutch bred gelding, Elegance by Negro. Elegance, who I said just now, just took her to her fifth Olympic Games in Tokyo. Horse that also she rode at the Dressage European Championships in Hagen. You remember her with Beauvalet, another horse, Fabergé, Delgado, horses that have been very instrumental in her career at top level competition. Zana, hope you're feeling okay, recovering from surgery and watching dressage. Also, yeah, watching from Australia. Good morning. evening. Can't remember. To have one of the very best watching as well. A lady that rode at the 72, 76, 84 and 88 Olympics, Jenny Lauriston-Clark. Former individual bronze medalist of the World Championships at Goodwood in 78. Just Ferris Salat. Climbing ninth, now sixth. Very good work in the massage, those transitions, Piaf to massage to Piaf, 7.5. There you can see Isabel in the grey on 78 and 8.4. Which is won now two Olympic medals. She was team silver in Athens and individual bronze. Rode at the very first European Championships in 2003 in Great Britain at Hixted. Got team silver and individual bronze there as well. And then in Hagen 2005, team bronze. 2015 freestyle dressage, bronze there. It's not going to be quite enough, is it? As she comes into her final passage to halt on the centre line, Beatrice Ferrer-Salat. And elegance for Spain. Sometimes takes a bit of time to get going in these series, and this is the second leg of nine. Madrid next at the end of November. And then on to London XL. Be very interested to see how that unfolds. But a very good test to watch from Beatrice Ferrer-Salat, and elegance. Bring you her score just 8 seconds. But it's going to be a win here today for Isabel Wirt by goal, 78.421. So Germany 1-2 with Frederick Vondra. Sit tight, bitch, as they keep you on your toes.
Mm-hmm.
so experienced now, Beatrice. Said road to the first Olympic Games in Atlanta in 1996. There it is, 75.026. Winder Barks from 73 up to 76.447. Goes fifth for Spain, elegance. And Beatriz Ferrer-Salat will round out the top five. We'll bring you the scores as soon as we can. Don't forget that tomorrow is Grand Prix Freestyle, and we will be bringing you all of that action live. And it's 3 o'clock, and there are the results. Isabel Wirtz is the out-and-out winner of today's Grand Prix Shorts. 78.421 with Var Gold for Germany. Germany also second. Frederick Vandras, Duke of Britain, on 75.947. Third for Denmark, Nana Skoberg-Merrild and Atrup Guards of Thilia on 75.342. Germany, four, Tarantino, Karina Schultz, 75.079. Moving further down the leaderboard, Catherine Dufour, sixth, with Vamos Amigos, Temos Vista, seventh, Morgan Babanso, eighth. And then we go to Antonia Ramel, Curiosity, for Sweden, 10th. And then in 11th, Denise Neckerman, Boston, Damien Michels, Intermezzo, Fornhead, Middelhoff, in 12th. But what a competition we have had. Down there in 15th, Marie-Emily Bretonneau and Pierre Vola, Silvermoons, Marie Chen, 16th for France. A brilliant competition and a brilliant way to get leg two underway here in Lyon. It was very close at the top. But there we just saw Nana Schoberg-Merrild and Atrup Guards of Thilia finishing third, 75.342. Second, Frederick Vandras, Duke of Britain. A brilliant round for him for Germany. Germany 1-2, Denmark 3. But this is the young man we can just see on our screens here of Damien Michels of Belgium. Intermezzo Fornhead Middelhoff, 70.395 for him. Some fabulous performances from some very exciting combinations. 4 o'clock local time, 3 o'clock is the Dressage World Cup Freestyle. And I'll be making my way down to Somerset, fingers crossed, to commentate from the studios in Somerset and bring you all of the freestyle dressage to music live. But a win today for Isabel Wirtz and Vargold, 78.421%. Taking home just over €4,000, 3,000 a second, just under 2,000 for our winner, Hetzkens Double Dutch, Temos Vistra. Just see the slow footwork of them, who eventually finished in seventh place on 72.474. The feisty little Hetzkens Double Dutch. Love watching him in the dressage. He's a real character, and they certainly know each other very, very well now. He's 13 years old. Frederick Vandras there.
Quel Grand Prix présenté par votre